Welcome to the intro to the quantum chemistry playlist. So let's define what quantum chemistry is. Quantum chemistry is the application of quantum mechanics to chemistry so that we can learn about the behavior of very, very small systems like electrons and nuclei. So quantum mechanics is the physics of very, very small objects. So when we say very, very small, what do we mean? We mean things that are microscopic, things that are on the order of nanometers in size, things that are very, very light, like the electron is, 10 to the minus 27th kilograms. So that's obviously very, very, very light and different from the types of objects we see every day, like humans and cars, the Earth, or any type of everyday object. And this is in contrast to classical mechanics, which is the type of physics of motion that we're used to for those everyday size objects. So let's just make a list here so we can compare and contrast the properties of quantum and classical mechanics. So quantum and classical. In classical mechanics, we're usually dealing with objects that are large, that is, they are larger than things that are like subatomic particles. They're usually quite heavy. And quantum mechanics, by contrast, is the physics of the very small and the very light. In classical mechanics, variables can change by very, very small amounts. If you think about the distance from the Earth to the Sun, that can change by any very tiny amount. If you think about the elevation we sit at above sea level, that can change by a very tiny amount. And thus, classical mechanics is what we call continuous. Things can change in very small, infinitesimally small amounts. Whereas in quantum mechanics, we have the opposite case, where there are only certain allowed values for variables. That is, they are discrete or quantized. And quantization is the base word of where quantum mechanics come from. Given that there are only certain allowed values of energy or position or momentum or all of those types of variables. In classical mechanics, what you usually try to solve to get a particle's position and properties over time are Newton's equations, things like F equals ma. In quantum mechanics, what we're going to be solving, what we'll introduce later, is the Schrödinger equation. So subatomic particles, very, very light things like electrons and nuclei, don't actually obey Newton's equations. They only obey them on average. The laws of motion that they follow are dictated by the Schrödinger equation, which we'll examine in detail later. So what you get out of solving Newton's equation would be a trajectory. You would get some position and momentum at every single point in time, and that is an exact map from point A to point B. That is what we call deterministic. That is, given any set of initial conditions, for example, if I give you the initial momentum and position of something like a bullet, and I tell you all the forces that are going to act on it over time and over space, you can solve exactly where that bullet will be as it travels through its path at any point in time. And whereas in quantum mechanics, we solve the Schrödinger equation to get a wave function. And this wave function tells us the likelihood of where the particle will be at any point in time. It's not deterministic. We don't get it exactly. It's instead called probabilistic, because the wave function just gives us probabilities where a particle is likely to be located at various points in space and in time. So this difference is that we have a lot of experience with classical mechanics because we have a lot of experience about how everyday objects move. We have an intuition about that, which has been developed for our entire lives. Whereas we have no real experience with things which behave as waves, things which only probabilistically obey the laws of motion. And so often quantum mechanics and many of the principles can be non-intuitive because we don't have that type of background that we've built up from studying these types of objects. The only types of objects we see in our everyday lives are classical objects, which are very large and very heavy relative to microscopic objects.